Hello everybody, it's me, GhostCritic, with my on Wednesday's new comic book day video. And it's been a weird old day regarding comics and going to collect them. Kind of sad and disheartening, to be honest, and I'll explain that in a minute. Because there was only going to be three books on my pull list this week, which is a travesty. It should have been four. I was lucky enough to pick up the one that I wanted but wasn't on my pull list, and there was one that I wanted to pick up that wasn't on my pull list because I wanted to try it first. And it's kind of indicative, really, of probably what is going on in a lot of the locally owned UK comic book shops. I mean, guys out there who in the UK who get comic books from their local comic book store, they don't get them in by a delivery. Please let me know if you are getting the kind of same experience that I'm now getting, because I don't know if a lot of you know, DC are putting out six Jack Kirby one-shot specials, kind of celebrating obviously his 100th birthday, and bringing back a lot of his creations. If you've probably seen this advertisement in a lot of the DC comics. And it all began last week with the New Gods one shot. And this is on me. I didn't realize it was so soon that these were coming out, so I haven't ordered any of them. But I thought it would be there on the shelves. It wasn't. Didn't have any, so I said, look, I want them all, so can you put them on my pull list and order in the New Gods, and hopefully I'll have it for next week, meaning this week. Now, this week, again, I'm not blaming anyone. A mess up probably on the order, but Howard Shaykin's The Newsboy Legion and The Boy Commandos was out this week. He didn't have it for me. He did ring up, find out where the order is, and hopefully this will all be sorted out. However, the New Gods is on kind of back issue order now because they don't have any. And this is what kind of saddened and disheartened me a lot, was that he hadn't ordered these at all, not even to go on the shelves, because he had heard no interest from customers in the slightest. And I did say to him, well, I'm surprised that you haven't got some sort of display up, you know, to celebrate his birthday. You can order these, put them on this kind of like display. You can put his trades on there to you know, sell those, put some back issues on display. Okay, they may be a bit pricier. And he said to me that it wasn't worth it. The people that were coming into the comic book shop now in present day don't care about Jack Kirby. You know, a 20-something coming in is just not interested in Jack Kirby. They probably don't even know who he is. And that saddens me so much. And again, it's not my comic book shop's fault. He is there, obviously, in his comic book shop day in, day out, and knows what his customers, and knows what he can sell and what he can't sell. So it just left me really disheartened and sad that, you know, someone who has created some of the greatest comic book characters, not only in DC, but at Marvel as well, and you 20-somethings out there, one, don't even know him, know about him, what his legacy has left, and two, don't care. It just saddens me so much. So apparently I'm the only one who's picking these up in my comic book store. He has none of these on order at all, apart from what I have got, what I have asked for. So it was like, oh. And it's not just the DC stuff, it's not just the Jack Kirby that he's not doing now. He's cut down on his ordering greatly. And basically, if you want anything new that's coming out, especially from kind of not necessarily DC and Marvel, but certainly from Image and anyone like that, you know, the independent comic book publishers, you need to pre-order them. He is not going to get them in any volume and put them on the shelves hoping that someone will pick them up and buy them and then put them on their pull list. You have to pre-order them without even having maybe seen a page of it, which is why I don't have Redlands either, because Redlands was out this week, the new Geordie Belair tie with Lana Del Rey, and I was really interested in that. I'd seen it hyped up a little bit. Hadn't seen anything of the interiors, but Geordie Belair, you know, solid colourist, artist. Be interesting to see what she was going to bring to the writing field, because I don't think I've ever read anything she's written. But he hadn't ordered a single copy because no one had ordered it. There was no interest in it. So that is the state of play. I'm going to have to start really looking at solicitations now, and again taking on chances on books that maybe I may not like, but I'm going to have to fork out at least an issue price to decide whether I like it or not. So yes, I've missed out on two books this week and one last week, which, like I said, last week my fault entirely, because I didn't order them expecting to see this kind of thing on the shelves. So it left me with four books. Fortunately, I managed to get one new number one that was out this week from DC. Before I show you those, we have some shout outs to give out. Seven new people subscribed to my channel over the last 7 days. Thank you very much. There was a flurry of emails coming in to my email box this week. And those people were, thank you again for joining me on my channel. Don't forget to comment in the comment section down below. Say hello. And one of these people, I'll be putting a link to their channel in the description bar below, and hopefully point you in that direction and see if you like what they're putting out. So we have Lake Murray Cards and Comics, Me Reads, Joe Martelli, Comic Fan 79 Texas, Guy Repair, Philip Holgate, and the Pieface 667. Now, the Pieface 667 is the only one of that list that has a channel with videos on it. It looks, from what I've looked at, he had a big break. He hadn't done a video for over 4 years, but he's just put up a new one now. If you're into gaming and you like watching people playing games, talking about their top 10 Xbox games, PS games, all that kind of stuff, their hauls, then that guy might be for you. So please go check out his channel if you have any interest in that whatsoever. So don't forget, if you subscribe in the next 7 days, you will also get a shout out in next week's video. And also, if you do channels, if your channel has regular video uploads, please, I will put a link in the description bar and point people your way. Sunday was my comic book review video, and it was a lot shorter because I only had four books. And it looks like next Sunday's video is going to be short as well. But thank you to everyone who watched that. If you're interested, because obviously with only four books on my pull list this week, I was like, okay, let's go and have a look in the back issue bins. I'll do a small comic book haul at the end of this video. So if you're interested in back issues at all, stick around. But let's have a look at those new books first, starting with DC. And we have the first part of Joshua Williamson's new storyline on The Flash called Negative, issue number 28. This is coming out of the last storyline where the Reverse Flash trapped our Flash in the Negative Zone, and he's come back with these kind of negative space powers. And they promised, well, not promised, they said that there was going to be a new costume. And I think the costume is just this kind of more black, negative style you can see on the cover. I think that pretty much runs through this whole issue. So a little, not necessarily a new suit, a new costume, but more of an adaptation because of where he's been. But been really enjoying that. The issue number one that I did pick up is Mr. Miracle issue number one. I think this is a 12 issue maxi series from Tom King. I'm expecting good things from this. I didn't get into his Marvel The Vision, which again was kind of a limited series. I don't know if it was meant to be that, but people talk very, very highly of this. Let's see if he can do the same kind of magic he did for The Vision over here at DC with Mr. Miracle. Looking forward to that. And two books from Image this week. We've got the third story arc from Brubaker, Phillips and Breitweiser on Kill or Be Killed. This is issue number 11. Great stuff from this creative team as always. I like the nice little surprise twist at the end of last issue where he delved a little bit more into the whole demon thing. And while we're still not sure whether it is real or if it's just in his head, Brubaker has certainly turned things around with an art gallery showing of his father's early kind of pulp kind of art style work where the demon actually shows quite prominently. So is this again just something he's incorporated in from seeing these pictures of his father's in his youth? Or is this some sort of family curse that's going on? Who knows, but I'm really, really looking forward to that one. Finally, from Rick Remender, it's Low issue number 19. As much as I enjoy Low, and I will continue for as long as Remender wants to write this, the choppy solicitations on this does not help this book at all in picking it up. There's no kind of momentum with it. Should be coming out monthly rather than this kind of patchy miss a month, miss a couple of months, come back with a couple of issues, then go away again. I don't know why that is. I don't even want to speculate. But it's always a great read. I feel it has a kind of finite storyline to it, and it may be coming to an end. I need to look into this, but that's a Low, so we'll see what that's about, and I'll give you my thoughts and opinions on all those books on Sunday. Before I go, let's have a look at some back issues. Very, as always, because I'm loving picking these up and such great stories. I'm still on my Conan kick. I have almost now finished my Conan run. This is issue number 2. Issue number 12. Great storytelling by Kurt Busiek and art by Karen Nord. Issue 13. Issue 39. Issue 41. And issue number 42. Just need one more issue of that now to finish that run off. The Brian Wood and James Harren run on Conan the Barbarian, issue number 4 and number 5. Almost finished that one off. And one Conan the Barbarian, issue number 24. And then his Marvel outing that kind of changed its name halfway through to Conan the King. I've got issue number 50, 50th issue special there. Issue 51, issue number 52. Guess what? Issue 53. And finally for the Conans, issue number 54. Also, there was a nice little run going over at Vertigo back in the early 2000s of Swamp Thing. And I don't know, I'm pretty sure it's probably my little sabbatical from comics, the year long that I had to, I missed out actually finishing this run. But with these, I have now. It's issue 23. Joshua Dysart on the book writing with various artists. Issue number 24, 25, 26, and to finish the run off, issue 29, which was the last issue of that run. And finally, 1FF, the last issue of the Matt Fraction and Allwood's run of FF, issue number 16. And that is all my comics this week. Thank you all for watching. I hope you're getting ready or to go to your comic book store and pick up. And I hope you have more luck than I did in picking up everything you want. Until Sunday, when I'll be reviewing those four new comics. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.